Earlier this month, in honour of freedom picnics for previously locked down Aussies, we shared this post on our Studio 10 Instagram.
Yes, we did.
We asked which four people you'd like to picnic with, and the options ranged from politicians to actors.
But it seems we left a very important person off the list. Australia's James Bond, George Lazenby, left a message for us commenting, "Seems you forgot me."
Well, now the legendary 007 actor is here to pitch to us why he would be the best picnic guest. George Lazenby, hello.
Yeah, hello.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for coming on the show. So just why would you be the ultimate picnic partner?
I would be the ultimate picnic partner. Well, because I cook, I swim, I have good hands, and I'm kind.
That's good recommendations.
Yeah, that ticks
a lot of boxes.
Yes.
I think you'd be good. What's your meal of choice?
Yeah,
the best thing you whip up?
The best thing I can whip up in the country, I always seem to do potatoes, but they're pretty boring. But I whip up, I can cook Indian food now.
Yum.
Mm. And,
depends what you can do with a spud, really.
Yeah.
That can be very exciting.
Yeah. It all sounds tasty.
Yeah.
Now, the star-studded world premiere of the latest Bond blockbuster, No Time to Die, took place in London. You got to see the flick in LA, otherwise you would have been over there. What do you think?
Think about LA or London?
No, I think about the new Bond film, No Time to Die.
Well, I hadn't seen a Bond film for some time, but they certainly had a lot of money. They had some stunts in there that you won't believe. And also, it was a little long, I think, but that's because I'm old. But on the other hand, you know, the girl was beautiful, very attractive. I like the young girl too, the little baby. I couldn't understand why she wasn't crying because she was my kid. They'd be bawling their eyes out under those circumstances. But on the other hand, you know, he did a good job. Not as good as mine, but it was acceptable.
Of course.
That's quote of the day. Not as good as mine, but acceptable. I like
it. You get a lot of bang for your buck when you go to see the new No Time to Die, that's for sure. George, I'm interested to know, do you think it's time that a woman plays the lead character? Are we ready for a female
Bond?
No.
I don't think women should go back to what they're supposed to be doing.
Oh,
taking care of men. And that's something I shouldn't say on television.
No, but, no, you shouldn't say it anywhere around the world, actually.
That's right, anywhere. But it's not true. It's not what's happening. And women have proved that they can do whatever a man can do. So if there's a woman that has the charisma of someone who's believable in that role, why not give her a shot?
Oh, so you think a female James Bond would be cool?
If she was believable, yes.
Well, I can think off the top of my head of at least 10 actors that fit that bill. And Daniel Craig is calling it quits. Now he's done. Would you go back for another shot? Sean Connery went back after a bit of a gap.
Yeah, this is a bigger gap, though. And I'd go back. You know, they pay you money that you can't refuse. They give you girlfriends. No, they don't give them to you, but...
Yeah,
girls
no.
That you never know, yeah. And you stay in nice places. I mean, who wouldn't go back?
So say, just on the off chance it's not you, who do you think should take over from Daniel Craig?
Well, I've got two sons coming along.
Oh.
And they'd be my first choice, Samuel and George. And he's got the same name, George Lazenby. And people weren't born when I was, and they could just have a good time. We'd find another Diana Rigg. It's hard, but you could. after I finished that film, I thought, geez, what a character Diane was. And how she behaved in a way where, yeah, it'd be a very interesting lady to live with.
She was an incredible performer, an incredible star, Diana Rigg. Hey, just quickly, the only Australian link there's ever been to the whole James Bond universe is you. In 25 movies, they never actually came and filmed in Australia. Why do you think that is?
Well, I don't know, but I had to change a lot of things to become English. You know, they talk funny. And they have... Yeah, they take life more seriously than the average Australian. So I had to pretend I was... I had to act. Oh. How about that?
Oh, what a nuisance.
Yeah. And then at the end, when I had tears coming out of my eyes and looked at the camera, and Peter Hunt said, James Bond doesn't cry. So I had to do the scene again without the tears. It was so hard. And because I fell for Diana. And it's interesting how things go. I didn't know. I used to learn my lines in the car on the way to work because I knew I'd be standing around forever waiting for them to get their stuff together. And the driver used to say, you're the only actor I've ever had who picks up his lines cold in the car. And I didn't know how actors operated because I'd never met an actor before I got that part.
You muddled through, I've got to say. You got through.
Yep.
We saw on Instagram you've been showing off some very cool merch, including a pistol. Did you pinch that from set? I'm imagining that's actually not for sale.
No, that was a recent thing. They hand you all sorts of stuff. When you're doing, these were selling shirts, I think.
Yeah.
And, a pistol's a pistol. Everybody's got one in L.A. It's like, you got to go and hunt through all the school bags and get rid of the pistols when they go to class. But it's a serious thing. It's an equalizer. Nobody wants to die. And I think, they're not the sort of thing I want my kids to play around with, yet I want them to understand them because there's so many. Mm. And you point them the wrong way and you're in trouble.
That's why sometimes it's better to be here in Australia,
yeah,
I think.
Exactly. And I think in terms of your merch, you might have just added another quote to your T-shirt repertoire there
this
morning. Yes, something that you said this morning that we won't repeat.
No, it was much more fun punching people than shooting them.
There's another slogan there.
That's right.
Hey, George, it's been lovely to catch up with you. We can't wait to have a picnic with you when you return to Oz. Is that something you're hoping to do?
I can't wait to return. I love to be in Oz right now. With my kids, just having a good time. There's food there that they didn't have when I grew up. You know, we ate English food. But now they've got Chinese and Indian and all kinds of Filipino. You can, and it's good quality. They compete very well.
We are spoilt for choice. There's no doubt about it. George Lazenby, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.